there, my name is Irene, and in this video, we are going to explore the concept of folding geometry, aka creating complex geometry out of introducing new lines and faces to a simple object. So let's get to it. Right, so the concept of folding geometry and the name itself is just something that I came up with in order to help explain how we can introduce complexity to SketchUp geometry. And the reason that I call it folding geometry is because when I'm working with SketchUp, I like to think about my SketchUp faces as paper. And thus, the concept of folding geometry is the idea of creating creases in paper to introduce more detail. So you can think about origami, for example. So let's start with something simple, right? So I'm going to start just with a face. I'm going to keep it on a perspective because we are going to be making deformations that will convert this 2D object into a 3D object. So what we want to do here is being able to convert these 2D face into a 3D object without having to use push-pull or follow me. Because up to this point, these have been the only two methods that we have been able to use in order to convert 2D faces into 3D objects. And as I mentioned before, the idea of folding geometry is that we are going to basically fold these faces. We're going to create creases, which are going to be lines, and then we're going to basically move the position of those lines to create creases. So again, this is a 2D face, but look what's going to happen if, for example, I come here and I'm going to draw a line from one end of this face to the other end of the face. Now we have two faces, nothing new up to that point, but if I come here and I select this line, and let's say I move that line, first thing that you're going to notice is that SketchUp is going to want to keep that line in the same working plane that it was created. But what I can do is use my arrow keys to force SketchUp to move it in a new direction. So I'm going to go up arrow key and whoa, look at this. All of a sudden, my object is no longer 2D, but 3D. But there's more, because you may notice that I am not getting the two original faces that I started with. I'm actually getting more creases on my paper, more folds. Because one of the rules of SketchUp is that when you deform geometry, SketchUp is going to do everything that is in its power to avoid those faces collapsing. And in some cases, that is going to mean introducing additional lines and faces. So the reason that I really like this method is that it gives me the option of working with SketchUp geometry in a more freestyle way, especially when you're working with push-pull, drawing a profile, or follow me. It is very restrictive, right? You have a profile, you have a direction, and you're just working within those boundaries. Here, I can look at a geometry and I can sculpt it in whatever way that I want. Like, let's say that I want to introduce another fold here. Well, no problem. I'm just going to draw another line that connects these two guys. And let's say that this time, instead of selecting a line, I can select a point. Remember, if you want to just select a point, you're not going to be able to select the point itself. So what you're going to do is you're going to go M for move and then highlight and click over the point. And then see, same thing. Now I'm creating an additional break. And then maybe I want to bring this guy like in a different direction and it's going to create a new form. So this is a very easy way to create super complex geometry because you're just creating folds, you're just creating creases on these faces and adding detail. I'm going to show you another way that you can use this. So let's say I'm going to delete this and I'm going to create another 2D face, but this time I'm going to create it on an elevated view. So let's say this is my face. And now what I can do is, again, let's say that I want to fold this. I want it to do a curved shape. Well, I can draw a line here. Now make sure that your line cuts through the entirety of the face. Like if I stop here, it's not really going to work the way that we want to. So I'm going to go Control Z and draw my continuous line. And then check this out. I can just select this top of my geometry, go to rotate. Let's use my arrow key in red to force it to go in a direction. And there you go. See, I'm creating a little fold. Now let's draw another little line here. Same thing, select Q, right arrow to select my working plane, and I can fold it a little bit more, and so on and so forth. So and as you can see, now I have quite the interesting curve in an object that started as a flat face. Again, this is how SketchUp does curved geometry anyway, so here we're just doing the same thing. Now, am I saying that this is the optimal way to create a curved object? Not necessarily, but there's gonna be instances where being able to manipulate the individual lines and faces in this freestyle form is going to allow you to create complex geometry very easily. And now to finish up, the last thing that I want to introduce here is how to get rid of these lines. Because one of the things that we can see with curved geometry created by SketchUp is that we should not be able to see these lines. So if you want to get rid of them, what you can do is you can select the entirety of the object, you're gonna right click, and then you're going to select soften smooth edges. This option is only going to be available when you are selecting raw geometry that includes lines and faces. So I'm gonna go soften smooth edges, and bam, you can see that immediately some of my lines have already disappeared. If I click outside, ooh, look at that. Now, if you're asking yourself, well, why didn't it hide these guys here? In order to understand that, we need to take a look at what are the settings of soft and smooth edges, which can be visible on your default tray. Now, this tab should appear automatically, but if it doesn't, no worries, you're gonna go to Window, Default Tray, and you just wanna make sure that you see Soften Edges. So basically, the way that Soften Edges works is it's an input command. Basically, what you are telling to SketchUp is, hey, you see two faces that are like this? Well, if the angle is more or less blank, you're gonna hide the line that is between those two faces. If the angle is more than blank, then you're gonna leave the line exposed. And that is what the slider here is telling me. It's basically telling me any two faces that the line between them is at an angle of less than 20 degrees, it will hide them. Any faces that the angle between them is more than 20 degrees, you will leave the line. So if I wanna hide these two other guys, all I need to do is increase, there you go, my degrees until it disappears. Now be careful. Don't go all the way, because what can happen sometimes, it's not doing it here because it's just a profile, but what can happen sometimes if you do this is that all of the lines disappear, and that's gonna make it very hard to work with that geometry. You definitely want to have some lines always visible. You can also check soften coplanars off, and I find that that usually fixes all issues, but then when you're done, you will have your own custom made curved surface. And with that, we have reached the end of this video. I hope you liked it. I hope you found it helpful. If you have any questions, by all means, feel free to add them in the comments. But otherwise, thank you very much for joining in. Thank you very much for sticking through, and I will see you in the next video. Bye!